Hi guys, I'm Raven, a mental health zen enthusiast, and welcome to my channel. If you're new here, what's poppin'? If you're a returning subscriber, what's goody? I'm gonna be giving you my top 10 Netflix recommendations for shows and movies related to mental health and psychology. So let's get into it. All right, so Netflix recommendation number one is actually a limited series called The Mind Explained. And this one's a lot of fun because it covers the topics of memory, dreams, anxiety, mindfulness, and psychedelics. This one's a really, really interesting one, filled with lots of information. I find this one really fascinating. And I like when they break up episodes into like topics. That makes my little heart happy.
Your brain is an association machine. It connects things together.
Why are memories so unreliable?
About 50% of the details of that memory change in a year, even though most people are convinced they're 100% right.
For thousands of years, humans have seen dreams as some kind of window into our deeper selves.
The brain in REM sleep looks uniquely different from any other time.
We keep inventing new reasons to be anxious.
Anxiety is the most common mental illness.
Why do so many of us feel this way? And what can we do about it?
Noticing your mind is lost, it's a moment of awakening.
How can a brief encounter with a psychedelic drug have such dramatic and varied effects? And what does that tell us about the mind? Mind, mind, mind.
Number two is The Creative Brain. This one's actually really interesting because it has some really cool interviews by creatives like Khalees. And I love Khalees because I consider her to be like a true artist. Not only do we know her from My Milkshake Brings All the Guys to the Yard, but we also know that she's a chef. She went to culinary school and learned how to be a real life chef. And I think that's so cool. So I consider Khalees to be absolutely an artist. I love it.
I think originality is bunk. I think it's nonsense. There never has been such a thing as true originality.
Creativity doesn't mean inventing something out of nothing. Instead, it's about refashioning what already exists.
The ideas that you have, the concepts that you have, are tools that will empower you to do more than you could without them. Before the Empire State Building was built, someone imagined it, then they built it, and now it's part of the real world.
Someone's like, that's weird. I'm like, yes, you know, because it means they don't know it, if they're unfamiliar with it. And that's always kind of what I'm trying to do.
I think science is inherently creative. I think you have to be to discover something new that other people have not discovered already.
Regardless of what you do for a living, creativity and the creative part of your being is essential to your happiness.
All of my experiences off the piano have something to do with what I'm doing on the piano.
After the Gulf War, I went to school trying to find something I could do for the rest of my life, and it just kind of happened with ceramics.
It's always easier to be a critic than a creator.
This is our chandelier.
I find myself when I write. I create a whole nother world, the world that I'm supposed to be living in.
Because of this experience in my life, I was able to be reborn inside. And I am somebody that I never knew I could be.
It's not like you kind of sit around on a silken cushion and ideas kind of come down. That doesn't actually happen.
To be creative, to think outside the proverbial box, you have to be willing to be wrong.
What do you have to do to be able to join in?
You have to try your best.
You have to try your best and you have to take risks.
Sometimes it hurts like hell and it's embarrassing and people get mad at you. It's hard, man. That's not a comfortable position all the time.
And of course, that is what creativity is, that we actually have the power to imagine the world that isn't our world yet.
Number three is Headspace, Guide to Meditation. I'm so happy this one's on there. I think more people need to know about meditation, and I'm glad that it's on a platform like Netflix, bringing it to more and more people. Meditation is so important, and each episode guides you through a meditation and a visualization, and I love it so much, guys. I highly encourage you to go check this one out, especially if you're like new to meditation. It might be cool to check it out. It's on an easily accessible platform like Netflix. I think it'd be really cool.
When was the last time that you did nothing? And by nothing, I really mean nothing. Hi, I'm Andy, and welcome to Headspace Guide to Meditation. Throughout this series, I'm going to be your guide as we explore the mind and discover how meditation can benefit us in our life. In each episode, I'm going to introduce a new technique and tell you how that technique can be used for specific situations. I hope meditation can bring you a greater sense of presence in your life, a greater ability to not be distracted, to enjoy life, and to connect with the people that you care about most. The best way of experiencing meditation is to actually do it, not to just talk about it. We're going to start with the eyes open and a nice soft focus, just aware of the space around you. And just take a moment before you do anything else, just to appreciate and enjoy that feeling of having stopped.
All right, number four is the social dilemma. Man, this one was really, really interesting. So you have all of these really brilliant, you know, tech experts who work at companies like Google and Facebook, and they've helped to develop these platforms, right? As amazing as these platforms are, they talk about the negative aspects that these platforms can have on us as social beings. They talk about the negative mental effects that these platforms can have. And so you really see the sort of dichotomy and the dissonance happening between them when they're giving you these interviews. It's really, really, really interesting. They talk about how ideally social media is there to make us more connected, right? As a human race, connect us, right? In more ways than we've ever been connected. But then it talks about how we're also more disconnected, right? It's made us sort of, we're like this, we're on our phone, we're connecting like this. So it's like, are we really more connected? You know what I mean? Man, it's really good. You gotta check out The Social Dilemma. I really liked it.
When you go to Google and type in climate change is, you're going to see different results depending on where you live and the particular things that Google knows about your interests.
That's not by accident, that's a design technique.
What I want people to know is that everything they're doing online is being watched, is being tracked. Every single action you take is carefully monitored and recorded.
A lot of people think Google's just a search box and Facebook's just a place to see what my friends are doing. What they don't realize is there's entire teams of engineers whose job is to use your psychology against you.
I was the co-inventor of the Facebook-like button.
I was the president of Pinterest.
Google. Twitter. Instagram.
There were meaningful changes happening around the world because of these platforms. I think we were naive about the flip side of that coin.
We get rewarded by hearts, likes, thumbs up, and we conflate that with value and we conflate it with truth.
A whole generation is more anxious, more depressed.
I always felt like fundamentally it was a force for good. I don't know if I feel that way anymore.
Facebook discovered that they were able to affect real world behavior and emotions without ever triggering the user's awareness. They are completely clueless.
Fake news spreads 6 times faster than true news.
We're being bombarded with rumors.
Everyone's entitled to their own facts. There's really no need for people to come together. In fact, there's really no need for people to interact.
We have less control over who we are and what we really believe.
If you want to control the population of your country, there has never been a tool as effective as Facebook.
We built these things and we have a responsibility to change it.
The intention could be, how do we make the world better?
If technology creates mass chaos, loneliness, more polarization, more election hacking, more inability to focus on the real issues, we're toast.
This is checkmate on humanity.
OK, Okay, so my number 5 Netflix recommendation is To the Bone. I watched this one quite a while ago, and y'all, it's really, really good. So, trigger warning, it does talk about eating disorder, I think specifically anorexia nervosa, if I'm not mistaken. I don't want to give too much away, but it has this really interesting resolve at the end of the movie that I think is really important for many people to see, especially young people, because anorexia nervosa and bulimia nervosa tend to affect younger people. And so I think it's really interesting for young people to watch this movie all the way through to the end and really see and experience that resolve. Another huge reason why I really like To the Bone, it really brings you to the level, you know, of this teenage girl and how she experiences her eating disorder. It's interesting to see how she rationalizes, and it's just a really good look at anorexia nervosa, and I really encourage you to check this movie out if it's something that you think will serve you.
All right, ready? 280 for the pork, 350 for the buttered noodles, 150 for the roll, and 75 for butter. It's like you have calorie Asperger's. That's not breakfast, neither is coffee.
You do a lot of sit-ups. I'm not going to treat you if you aren't interested in living.
Good speech. I've got it under control.
Isn't it funny?
It's a cake. I've got it under control. I've got it under control. You okay, honey?
I just got up too fast.
So, welcome to our new house member, Alan.
Hi.
Oh, my God.
How do you do it? Eat, I mean.
I'm not gonna lie. I'm really fucking hungry.
Huh? You look like a ghost. I feel kind of angry. It's my life, too. I don't get to have a sister.
What's going on with you?
I just don't see the point.
People say they love you. But what they mean is they love how loving you makes them feel about themselves.
I don't even know where to start with that. There's all kinds of wrong.
The way that you're going, one day you won't wake up.
I can't stop.
Every time you hear that voice, I want you to tell it to fuck off.
Fuck off, boys! Somebody tell me why we're here!
Because we're alive.
Very good.
Some of them actually seem like they're doing okay. Like they might get lives and be semi-interesting people.
Did you just say something optimistic?
I did say semi.
My Netflix recommendation number 6 is The Secret. Y'all, I have to throw this in here. The Secret literally changed my life. It changed how I look at life. It changed how I experience life. And I gotta throw The Secret in here because The Secret really shows you how to utilize your brain to your advantage, because your brain is gonna brain whether or not you allow it to brain. You know what I'm saying? Your body, your mind, and your spirit are all gonna work together in one accord in order to attract things to you. You're always attracting and manifesting, sometimes good things, sometimes bad things, but The Secret is gonna teach you how to use what your brain is gonna do anyway, whether or not you believe it or not, you're attracting things. Our minds are the most powerful tool that we own, you guys, and The Secret is going to teach you how to use it to your advantage. I love The Secret, and I had to throw this in here because I want every single person in the world to watch it. Please, please, please go watch The Secret, okay?
Throughout history, all the great minds, all the great leaders, all the great achievers, they had something in common. Now the great glimmering of truth can be revealed again.
You know, this secret gives you everything you want. happiness, health, and wealth.
You can have, do, or be anything you want.
I've seen many miracles take place in people's lives.
Financial miracles, miracles of physical healing, mental healing, healing in relationships.
All of this happened because of knowing how to apply the secret.
Recommendation number 7. I'm holding up 5 fingers. Number 7. All right. Take Your Pills. This was such a good documentary. A Netflix documentary highlighting America's low-key dependence on stimulus ADHD drugs like Adderall and Ritalin. Okay, y'all, no tea, no shade, but in my undergraduate career, I was going to a pretty major university down here in Texas. And over time, I realized low-key, a lot of people were on Ritalin or Adderall. Really a lot of Adderall. It was pretty crazy. And you guys, I cannot tell you how damaging and unhealthy that is. Like, if you don't have a prescription for it, you shouldn't be taking it. That's just my opinion. It was pretty crazy. And they were doing these things in order to keep up, in order to have the energy to study. Get the good grades. But it's like, girl, baby girl, straight A student, okay? I get really good grades and I got kids, okay? I finished my undergraduate degree and my baby was a little bitty baby. And now I have 2 kids and I'm getting ready to start graduate school, going to graduate school to become a therapist, by the way. But I did these things without the Adderall and stuff. I get an energy drink. I don't know what to tell you. Don't come for me. I don't know what to tell y'all. I just get real scared about a bunch of young kids going around taking drugs. It just make me real nervous. I don't know what to tell you. Maybe it's the mom and me making me real nervous. It's really, really crazy to see what these kids go through and the pressure that they experience and the extremes that they'll take to get ahead or to impress, I don't know, their parents, who knows.
I learned about ADD after being on the medication. I didn't know what it was. All I knew was for school.
And then when I got here and I was like, holy shit, everybody takes Adderall, everyone. I take it right when I wake up. It takes about 40 minutes to kick in and you can feel it. I start to sweat. My heart accelerates.
My handwriting got neater. I thought that was so cool.
My mind came alive. My body felt alive.
It works like a bang.
Adderall, warning. Side effects may include being awesome at everything.
Every generation has found a different way to try to enhance their performance. Now, in this case, it has been ADHD drugs.
This ain't new.
It's not like a glass of wine or a joint or any way that people use to decompress. I really see it as a supplement, as a tool.
And I don't think there's anything wrong with that.
So then you're primed that a pill is gonna give me what I want.
I felt this like mounting pressure from work to start using my prescription.
And that says something about our culture right now.
It makes me kind of depressed.
We probably have meds for that.
Everyone has a little ADD.
No, we have distractions, but not everyone has a brain that functions like somebody's with ADHD.
I wouldn't say that I'm happy to have Adderall, but I'm happy that Adderall is an option for you.
There are cardiovascular risks, psychotic episode. You wouldn't wish that on your worst enemy.
I've got everything I wanted, and there's no way any of that would have been possible without the medication.
The perfect employee is somebody that doesn't say no. There is a culture of you do stay up 16 hours for 7 days straight. I've had a seizure from exhaustion.
You want to be beautiful and you want to have amazing grades, and Adderall just sort of sews it all up for you.
Adderall, the drug of our time.
this focus on material progress and productivity, what's the cost of that? And is that a cost we're willing to live with?
Okay, Netflix recommendation number 8 is a movie called Babies. It's just a documentary. Well, I shouldn't say just. It is an amazing documentary on babies and how we grow and develop. And this is delving into the realm of developmental psychology, if that's something that interests you. It's just really interesting to see how we grow and develop from babies into these adults, right? It's really interesting to see just how advanced babies like already are when they're so young. They're doing some pretty gnarly, pretty advanced, you know, pretty complicated stuff when they're just these little babies who can't even walk sometimes yet. So really, really interesting if you're interested in like human development. Go check that out.
Babies are the ultimate mystery. They're much more complex than we ever thought.
Isn't it amazing that the answer to what it means to be a human lies in the smallest, youngest creatures, our babies?
I love babies. Oh.
In the first year of life, babies are growing faster than they ever will. They can wake up in a different body than they went to sleep in.
Where's your mommy? Yay!
Walking changes every part of the baby's lives.
Oh my God! Oh my God! Richie just walked!
He just walked!
It's just fascinating to watch him become his own person.
What's this one? Hussy!
Bubble! We can hear where she's trying to actually say words now.
You say space?
When my oldest daughter was born, I felt what it means to love.
We realize now that even the very youngest babies already know more and learn more than we ever thought possible.
Give her a kiss. Aww.
Okay, Netflix recommendation number 9 is Diagnosis. Y'all, this one was really, really interesting to me. So this one isn't necessarily a mental health or psychology show, but it is. Okay, so what it is there are these people out there with these very rare diseases and disorders, right? Not necessarily related to the mind or the brain or anything, but almost every single episode had some sort of component related to the brain, the mind, or mental health, right? So for example, there is a little girl who continues to have these seizures. She has these seizures like around the clock. So not related to mental health, but related to the brain. Really interesting.
What if social media could save lives? Stay, 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 stay. Right now, there are literally millions of people struggling with undiagnosed medical conditions.
I'm Brittany, Kamaya's mom. She's 6 years old. She's paralyzed anywhere from 3 to 20 seconds over 300 times a day.
I was in the Gulf War. I served 8 years, and now I'm losing my memory.
Every time the deja vu happens, I feel my eyes roll in the back of my head, and then I flatline.
Sadie has this incurable disease that the only thing you can do is, you know, remove half of her brain. How could that be the only thing you do to a kid?
My body is going through something. The doctors are like, we can't help you.
I want to know if somebody else has this.
They need something different. The kind of thinking that happens usually outside the hospital.
I'm Dr. Lisa Sanders, and I'm a physician at Yale. And for the past 15 years, I've written a column for the New York Times Magazine about patients who have mysterious symptoms. But I always wanted to go the next step. Using the internet, we have the ability to harness all the intelligence of people around the planet to get some answers.
I was thrilled to see that many responses.
It's what we hoped for.
Never, ever, ever give up.
There is somebody out there that understands.
The symptoms align perfectly with the things that I've experienced.
There's another mom out there like me that was looking for an answer. We're not the only ones.
You gotta keep a positive attitude.
It's the good news.
We can create a movement. There's hope.
1, 2. Are you trying to kick me?
No! I did not do it on purpose.
I know.
All right, my last Netflix recommendation. This one's a little different. This one is called Freud. The show is based on Sigmund Freud, one of the founding fathers of psychology. But it's not like a, it's not, I don't know whether or not it's historically accurate. It's more like a TV drama. But it's really interesting and it's based on Sigmund Freud. I thought it might be fun for some of you psychology lovers out there. That is all I have for you today, you guys. Thank you so, so, so much for watching. I'm so grateful to have you here. Don't forget to like this video. It helps me so much. Please leave a comment down below. I love to hang out in the comment section and talk with you guys. And don't forget to subscribe. Please, please, please subscribe. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and I will see you next time. Bye.